At the beginning of the war, our army noticeably lacked large-caliber weapons that could destroy German equipment. Therefore, Semenov and Degtyarev, Russian designers, in a short period of time were able to develop PTRs, anti-tank rifles, to help soldiers at the front. The soldiers had absolutely different opinions about this gun. From the disadvantages, guns had a weak effect against heavy tanks of the enemy. Only an accurate hit to the equipment and even the sight window of the tank crew could inflict serious damage. Naturally, this did not always work. There were also complaints from soldiers about the capriciousness of the weapon. The casings would get stuck and could only be removed with some heavy object and easily damage the APC itself. Also, sand was getting into the bolt carrier. The gun could only be fired from a distance of no more than 400 meters, and it was difficult for ordinary soldiers to approach or let enemy vehicles near at such a short distance. After the first shot, the Germans easily tracked the positions of the Soviet soldiers. As a result, very many were killed without even hitting a single tank. The advantage was that the gun was an excellent aid in destroying Nazi armored vehicles, light vehicles, and bunkers. The use of PTRs was able to help the fighters in knocking out a decent amount of enemy equipment. But it is worth saying that they did not have the effect that is shown in movies about the war.